Hi, my name is Denis Lifensev, and here we talk about cross-cultural communication. In this video, I want to share with you some useful information about how to communicate with Bulgarians. Bulgaria is one of the oldest and largest countries in the European Union. Whether you are going to have a business meeting in Sofia or planning your summer vacation in Varna, Burgas or Sozopol, you need to know how to communicate with Bulgarians. From my personal experience, Bulgaria is a lovely country with beautiful nature and amazing people. I really enjoyed exploring southern touristic regions during my summer vacations, but probably most interesting experience was working with the students of Dmitry Tsenov Academy of Economics in Svishtov in 2017, when I had the pleasure to deliver lectures on cross-cultural communication during my Erasmus academic mobility. Bulgarians are really warm and hospitable people, but sure, there are some tips that might make your communication even more pleasant and comfortable. To understand better how to communicate with Bulgarians successfully, I've asked several questions to my good friends and colleagues.
Petar Todorov is a senior lecturer in English in Dmitry Tsenov Academy of Economics. Let's listen to his opinion about Bulgarians and Bulgarian communication style.
I can't really think of three words, but one word is for sure, and it is hospitable. Okay, Bulgarians are very hospitable people, and they like welcoming guests, showing them certain things, and Bulgaria is a country which has beautiful nature, has all four seasons, and it's very good for tourism. We also have very rich historical and cultural heritage. Unfortunately, part of this heritage is that for 500 years we were part of the Ottoman Empire. There are many words in Bulgarian that are actually Turkish, and it is explicable because of this part of our history. One thing that you need to know is that we have given to the world the Cyrillic alphabet. The brothers Cyril and Methodius invented the Cyrillic alphabet. Okay, sports, music, food, entertainment in general, these could be good topics. Okay, recently on TV, there have been many Turkish serials, so many people love them, others hate them. So in relation to the next item, which is topics to avoid in conversation, so, okay, Turkish serials could be a topic to talk about or topic to avoid. Okay, there aren't any specific taboos for Bulgarians. Politics, okay, that would very much depend on the situation. Roma people, okay, that would be another topic that is, tricky to handle, tricky to deal with. Well, communication style would not differ much from, other communication style. There aren't any specific rules that you need to know. Okay, one thing that I would point out is that kissing at first meeting is not common in Bulgarian. Okay, when people know, they could kiss, of course. But at first meeting, when you meet someone for the first time, at least for me, it's not appropriate to kiss as it is in other cultures. Nowadays, many Bulgarians, or I should say most Bulgarians, especially young people, speak English, so if it is an international meeting, if it is an international context, even if it is in Bulgaria, English could be used as the language of communication. Some words that it is good to know. Okay. Здравей or здравейте. This is hello. Okay. So. Здраве. This means health. And it's a noun, and when you add this, it becomes a verb. So it is здравей, This is the informal form, and здравейте, this is the formal, the polite form. Okay. Next you have довиждане, this is goodbye. And again it means довиждане. Виждане means to see someone, and до means until. So basically it would mean until we see each other again. In an informal conversation, you can use the Italian ciao. It's normal in Bulgarian to use ciao instead of довиждане for goodbye. Okay, next one is благодаря. This is thank you. However, it might be difficult, благодаря, it might be difficult to pronounce it. So instead of this, you can use the French merci. Okay, merci is normal to use in Bulgarian. Bakshish. Okay, this is the word origin, this is a Persian word, and you can come across it in Turkish, of course, so one of the Turkish influences in Bulgarian. So bakshish has two meanings. One of the meaning is a tip, money, additional money that you give to a waiter in a restaurant, in addition to the bill, okay? Davam bakshish means to tip a waiter. But another meaning is a taxi driver. So this word is a derogative for a taxi driver. And this is because, okay, taxi drivers would like to receive a tip. Okay, rakia is another word that you must know in Bulgarian. It's a strong alcoholic drink, spirit. It is made of usually of grapes or plums. And interesting thing about rakia is, okay, I'm gonna show it to you. Okay, so this isn't whiskey, but this is rakia inside, in the bottle. Okay, and interesting fact about it is that you would find this in every Bulgarian home, rakia in a whiskey bottle. And what is interesting, why is it in a whiskey bottle? Because in the past you couldn't buy whiskey in normal shop. There were certain shops that were called Korekom, and they sold Western products, and you could only shop them if you had currency, foreign currency, like dollars, like Deutsche Mark. Okay, and so those people who could buy whiskey, they would then keep the bottles because it was a rarity. And when they drank the whiskey, they would fill the rakia, homemade rakia, in this bottle.
Thank you, Petar. And now let's listen to the opinion of Bulgarian Generation Z, young people who are going to shape future economic landscape in Bulgaria. Violina Kirilova studies international economic relations, and she is a president of the Erasmus Students Network in Svishtov.
Hello everyone, my name is Violina and I'm from Bulgaria, and now I'm going to share with you some interesting facts about us, Bulgarians. So let's get started with the first point. Three words to describe Bulgarians. Well, I can say that we are emotional, we are kind, warm people, and also we are curious. So let's move on to the second one. How would you describe Bulgarian style of communication? Well, I can say that it's kind of complicated one. As I said, we are warm people, and in general we don't have problems to communicate with others. But most of the cases, foreigners misunderstand us, or we misunderstand them, because of the gestures which we use, especially this with our hands. For example, in other countries in European Union, they express no like this. But in Bulgaria, we express no like this. In other European countries, they express yes like this. But we express yes like this. You see, it's totally opposite, and because of that, our conversation is kind of complicated and confused one. So please just keep this in your mind that in Bulgaria the gestures are the opposite one from this in Europeans one. Okay, so let's move on to the third point. topics pleasant for Bulgarians. I think we most like to speak about what we are going to do in our free time. We like to speak about food or some kind of entertainment and adventures or books or music. Just about the things which make us smile and enjoy life, but also sometimes we like to complain a lot. Yes, so let's move on to the fourth point. Topics we should avoid. I think that the two worst topics to speak with Bulgarians are politics and money. Yeah. So let's move on to the fifth point. Couple of funny words to make locals smile. Okay, I have three ones for you. One of them is the word farfalak. We use this when we want to describe a very small kid. The next word is krokozoben, when we want to describe that something or someone is terribly ugly. And the final word is kukundrel. We use this word for a woman who is in the middle age but uses very strong makeup and very inappropriate clothes for her.
I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching my channel. If you want to know more about different national communication styles, click subscribe and watch other videos on my channel. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.